Alrighty then, back once again for another reaction. This time it's MLP, Season 8, Episode 21, A Rockhoof and a Hard Place. Yeah, kind of on the nose there, but a Rockhoof episode. Nice to see a pillar of return that isn't just Arswell. I have been wondering where those fellas dropped off the edge of the earth to. So, it is cool that we're finally getting to see at least one of the other pillars. Like, we've not checked in with Flash, we've not checked in with Sonambula, although we did go back to her hometown again. We haven't seen Meadowbrook, you know, none of those guys, but hey, I'm glad that we're seeing someone, you know, that is something. So I don't know what we could possibly do with this character, considering he's the big lunky dude that has the shovel and the raw strength, but and he has all this Nordic influence in his design and his culture. But we'll have to see. I think he might be paired up with someone to make the dynamic a little more interesting. I don't think this will be a solo episode. I don't see the kids caring much if it's just Rockhoof on his own. Let's find out. Home sweet home. As rocky as ever. Hello, just a living legend coming through.
You're going to have to work faster than that if you plan to dig up my whole village, lass. Let me
I forgot that he talks like he's from How to Train Your Dragon.
Thank you, Rockhoof. But we're trying to carefully preserve every bit of history here.
Aye, this place is full of memories. Did I tell you about the time our chieftain knocked down
You're going to break something with that.
Kick of a wee ball?
Stop that!
But that's what this is for.
Maybe in the past.
Oh, wow.
Now it belongs in a museum.
We're dealing with the consequences.
Untouched.
Oh, okay.
Next you'll be saying I shouldn't have used the old sweat lodge.
I see.
You see why Rockhoof isn't an ideal fit for my team. Perhaps you could use his unusual talents?
Of course, Professor Fossil. We'd be honored Professor to have a pillar Fossil. Of Equestria on our staff.
Oh, thanks, Celestia.
Oh, that apple's made of wood. What a horrible trick to play.
Has any pony seen my decorative centerpieces? They were right here.
Good luck!
Okay.
And I don't think you see the places inside me that I find you.
And I don't know how we separate the lies here from the truth.
And I don't know how we woke up one day, somehow thought we knew exactly what we're supposed to do. So leave me at the roadside and hang me up and out to dry.
Okay, so he's like a bit too far from the pass, I guess. Some things are a bit
thank
more
you,
modern
thank
for him.
You all. I know I'm new to your world, but there's one
thing I
learned when I saved my village from a rushing river of hot lava. There's nothing you can't do with hard work and a shovel.
To murder your enemies with.
Except maybe stand on stage.
Nice effort, Spike.
Every creature dismissed. We'll see you in class.
You think that new pony is gonna be the weirdest teacher at school? Or just one of the weirdest?
Yeah, we're gonna say, don't count out Pinkie Pie.
Like yak!
And he smashes things like a yak, smells like a yak.
Yes!
Yona has a favorite teacher.
He's like pony history.
Hello, class!
Smash! He's like a Wreck-It Ralph.
I'm your new theory and defensive friendship teacher. But I haven't had a chance to look at Headmare Twilight's notes yet. What have you all been learning?
We just studied all about how Princess Celestia and Luna used a spell to trap Discord in Stone Sleep for hundreds of moons.
Stone Sleep. He was very much awake.
So it's a class about stories, is it?
Stories, yeah. And we never, ever, ever get homework.
Good. The best way to
I love that they included that. That is what you
experience.
Tell the substitute teachers.
Like the time I was in the woods and ran across an Ursa Major.
Really? We're not doing that, right?
You fight Ursa Major? All alone?
Aye, and I defeated her too.
Now this, I'm interested in. How Professor Rockhoof win?
Well,
bonked him with my shovel.
Quite a tale.
From what Professor Fossil said, it sounds like Rockhoof just hasn't settled into modern times yet. Our school is
very interesting conflict.
Plus, we get a new teacher.
Someone very oldish in their ways trying to adapt to modern life. That's really cool.
Shovel leap, shovel throw. Shovel whack.
I like how the kids are loving it.
The Ursa Major. Lots of growl in mind.
Maybe classrooms were less breakable in the old days.
They were made of rocks.
What happened next?
The huge beastie jumped out of the moonlit mist. Their fearsome fangs at my throat. But I rolled clear.
You should seriously consider performing on stage
wall,
in plays.
Ready to pounce.
On second thought, he'd break the stage. Never mind.
Me. And I say...
Professor Rockhoof?
Nope, guess again. oops.
Sorry to interrupt. Class, why don't we go ahead and take lunch early today? Rockhoof, can we take a walk outside?
I thought they'd be a bit more disappointed that that story ended.
Our school is about finding your own special way to teach.
And we can already tell you're a smash.
He's so big.
But maybe you could do a little less smashing in the classroom.
Sorry about that. I did get a bit carried away. The students were so interested in my tale.
I know it's a big change, but I think you're gonna fit in just...
Whoa, okay, some students are dying.
Fire!
Rockhoof, wait!
No time! The building's ablaze!
Okay, is that cooking?
Professor Rockhoof, best teacher ever!
Oh, is it...
Cannot get better!
Pottery?
Let's get you outside, wee ones!
They just got better!
I love how Yona's, like, so enamored.
Rockhoof?
What are you doing?
Saving the school!
Saving the school! By doing some smashing!
Just like fighting a volcano in the good old days!
Would some pony kindly explain what is the meaning of all this water? I'm not sure!
I like her... Oh, gosh. Rarity's just going to keep getting inconvenienced, isn't she?
Put out the rage in Inferno.
Inferno? Where?
Did you not see the smoke and flame?
Yeah, that was us.
Oh.
You know, dragons, having a fire-breathing competition.
Oh, okay.
What?
They do it all the time. That's what we were trying to tell you.
We know you're used to being a hero,
It still seems like a hazard, though.
What we need here is a teacher.
One who doesn't ruin an entire class's friendship quilts. I don't know how hard it is to stitch a pineapple pattern.
But there are no yellow sponges on it, so it's not that great.
I'm not used to living with dragons, or much else in this modern time. Professor Fossil made it clear I'm not welcome back in my old village.
Well, it's your village. You can tell her to get out. How can you not be welcome in your own village? Like, you're the hero.
So
you have more swaying power.
A new job is a lot harder than we thought. Has any pony had any luck?
Nope. I thought you were gonna try him out of the post office.
We did.
Do
you
He's been smashing things up.
Frankie Doodle Donkey. I need to deliver his medicine. He has a rash in a very embarrassing place.
Oh my. Good joke.
I did not need to hear that.
Yep. Rockhoof's time as a spa masseuse didn't work out either.
Oh my. Are you trying to
now
kill people?
Just let me know if this is too much pressure.
Uh-huh. Damn lucky you didn't try that on anyone else.
At least Rockhoof's really strong. Maybe we could find him a job carrying
labor
stuff. I tried that already. Sakura needed somebody to help her get supplies, but...
I know you said you only needed a few leaves, but I figured why not bring you the whole thing?
That's just unfortunate. That's just a bit of bad luck.
None of the other pillars seem to be having trouble fitting into the modern world.
Can we see them?
Then maybe they can show Rockhoof how to
okay.
To get him used to living in this town.
Great idea.
I did wonder how we'd fit them all in by the end of the season.
And I said he'd love to visit them.
Okay, yeah, this is a good idea.
Even Canterlot looks different from the old days.
Oh,
there's so much more assholery going around.
Magnus, you'll feel right at home.
Trot, 2, 3, 4. Trot, 2, 3, 4.
Uh-huh.
Keep it lively, rookies.
I knew he'd be right
Here's
at home.
On site. Company, halt!
Rockhoof, you old ditch digger, you.
Flush, Magnus, as I live and breathe. Is this your squadron?
After we got out of limbo, I went looking for work for a pony with experience in the Royal Legion. Once a soldier, always a soldier.
That is
Princess
so cool.
Lesbia was happy to find a new drill sergeant for her guard.
Yeah, that's great. She really put you in a job that big so soon?
Oh, this is nothing. You should see what Miss Main is up to.
Oh yes, what is Miss Main up to? Ooh.
Hey, babe, you the royal landscape artist for the Crystal Empire?
That is really cool.
Your work is beautiful.
No, thank you. I've never
What a follow-up episode.
Before, but in my heart, I know I'm where I belong.
You always could find the beauty in things, but there's not much demand for shovel ponies like me nowadays.
I like how this episode is playing off my worry before the episode even started. I was also thinking about how limited his applications are, and that's literally the conflict. I love it.
Ponies knew what to do with their lives.
Focus on my voice. And feel yourself unlock your potential.
The one with the awesome voice.
Imagine everything that troubles you as one big cloud. Now,
I like how we now have a new reference pose for pony fan art. The yoga pose.
Free to do anything you wish.
Uh-huh. Yeah, very cool that we got to see what Twilight looks like, sitting cross-legged.
Mage Meadowbrook, your home looks just the same as the old days.
I could see
oh, now it's like
mine.
A pharmacy.
Well, I've had to expand my clinic a bit.
Uh-huh.
Many creatures need healing in this modern world. Oh, looks like you could use some too. What's got you heartsick, Rockhoof?
Thing is, I can't do my old job like Flash, or adapt like Miss Main, or succeed at something new like Somnabula, or go home.
Be a traveling hero.
Give it time. Even Starswirl's still learning about friendship.
Oh, yeah. Form a duo with Starswirl.
And I bet Stygian took plenty of time to fit in.
Hey, look what I found. Me and My Shadow, the third hit novel by
Wow, he's a novelist.
I'm impressed.
I love it.
He's really thriving. Rockhoof, where are you going?
I'm not sure. Maybe I just don't belong in this modern world.
So what, are you off to limbo again? What are you going to do with yourself?
Mash of apples. Instead of solving Rockhoof's problem, we made him feel even worse.
Get him on the farm.
We haven't given Rockhoof the chance to be who
Have him
he really
knock
is.
On those apples.
A pony with the metal shovel
with just the right amount of force.
A hero! What we need to do is find him a job that's as epic as he is. I might know just the thing.
Oh, goody.
I'm honored to serve in the Hippogriff Navy, General Seaspray. I promise I'll prove my worth.
Okay.
Nothing of it.
Can you make this work?
How hard it is to adapt to a new
home. Love the sailor uniform.
After our many years below the waves, land customs seemed strange.
Did you always have those scars, or did I just not notice them before?
As though the world had moved on without us. Never fear, Rockhoof. We shall be as brothers in this bright future above.
I'm not sure I remember those scars when we saw them in the earlier episodes. I might have to rewatch.
Maybe they just like cruises?
General, the fog's too thick to see our way out of the harbor.
Heave to, swabbies! Hold the ship and hold her till the fog passes!
I really like this ship.
You can navigate the same way my cultic ancestors traveled through the silky mists. We'll look to the stars! There in the northwest sky is the constellation for O'Brien's belt. Steer the ship toward that.
You heard the pony crew. Make full sail!
Okay.
Yee-haw!
Yeah, that's true. They did have sailing knowledge.
But I don't understand. The stars have always steered me true.
No, stars can move slowly over time. They must look different now.
Oh, that's so clever!
It was an honor serving with you, Rockhoof. But it seems our paths lie in different directions.
That was really clever because the star map will move. That is so cool. I've said the word cool so many times, but that's what this episode is.
Really?
I think that was really clever that they did that.
There's a statue spell that sends creatures into stone sleep. I want you to cast it.
Whoa, dude! I was thinking about a suicide joke earlier when you said that there's no place for you in this world, but I didn't because it was going to be inappropriate.
No!
You just pretty much...
Hey guys,
okay.
Need me to help you decide something?
Yeah, I want to be sealed away forever.
Turn him into a statue. The answer is no.
Well, it should be I, because I wouldn't even be here to be turned into a statue if Twilight hadn't cast a spell in the first place.
Whoa, I thought you were arguing over ice cream flavors.
I wish.
The answer is still no. Why would you want
My favorite is sea salt and caramel ice cream.
Because I'm a relic of a bygone age. I belong in a museum. Safe, preserved, untouched. I don't belong in this time. It's up to you to make that right.
But there has to be a better way.
Twilight, please understand. I want to be remembered as the hero I was, not the disappointment I've become.
But you're not.
Deep.
Rockhoof, wait! Spike, can you teach my class today?
You're not really going to turn him to stone, are you?
Only because it's temporary. As soon as I think of a new solution, we'll wake Rockhoof up. I
really?
Know there's more to offer the world as a pony than a statue.
Did you
really?
Hear cut all the bees in
okay,
the forest
I'm surprised she'd go that far.
Well, Terramar said Rockhoof called down the stars and sunk the whole Hippogriff Navy.
He's definitely weird, but in a fun way. You never know what's going to happen next with him. Professor
yeah,
Rockhoof
this has been a lot more fun than I thought it was going to be.
Welcome to the Theory and Defense of Friendship.
Another sub? Let me start by telling you that we don't get homework and we only do field trips.
Yeah, nice try. Twilight said
today we're going
to
be saying, "Oh, Dragon, my dragon."
Stone sleep spell on Rockhoof.
Like Discord? But why? Rockhoof isn't a bad guy.
Your instructions.
But he doesn't want to be here anymore.
An essay on heroism and what it means to you.
No.
Oh, don't worry. It doesn't have to be a long essay.
Maybe like this.
Mainly because I have a short attention span, and I'll give up reading halfway through.
Fewer places to decorate.
Professor Rockhoof, Dragon said you want to turn into.
Aww. Yona's favorite teacher!
I'm afraid it's true, lass.
But Pony need finish Ursa Major story for class!
It's sweet of you to try to get me to stay, Yona. But I'm afraid old stories like mine aren't worth anything in this day and age.
Fine! If Pony no want tell Yona story, then Yona tell Pony story.
Oh! Oh! Okay.
From class report, when Yona come to Pony school, Yona not fit in. Pony ways strange, but Yona find friends. Yona meet Professor Rockhoof. Pony brave and strong as yak, not afraid, hero. When Yona grow up, Yona want to be just like Professor Rockhoof.
Well,
that is so sweet.
Since you went to the trouble of writing something that nice.
It's really cool as well that him being the way he is very yak-like, and she loves that about him. Oh, it's so sweet.
School rock of his best. Now I want to hear story.
Okay, I have the spell, but will you please?
The suicide has been cancelled, Twilight.
The Major tried to grab me by the gullet, by Dr. Claus. She had me cornered, so I look at her, she looks at me. And I say, sorry, you won't be having any dinner tonight, lass. Guess you'll just have to grin and bear it.
Wow.
And then I tossed her away with my shovel.
That's how you know you're a badass. You have time to make a pun when fighting a big killer.
Or so I'm told. And that's the end of my story.
One more story! One more story!
No, no, thank you for listening, but it's time to say goodbye.
Wait, you said there wasn't anything in this time you were good at.
Storytelling!
Telling stories.
It was just a tall tale.
One that captured the hearts and imagination of every creature here.
Plus, pony stories! Super fun!
As the Princess of Friendship, I'd like to appoint you as Equestria's official Keeper of Tales. Can you do that?
Yes. Yes. Shut up, Spike. She can.
That's very kind of you. But I still think these old bones are more suited to a museum display.
Why don't you tell the tales at the museum?
Record of our history. Your stories can inspire and teach generations to come. If you're a statue, that's all lost.
But will I ever really belong in your world?
Rockhoof Yona's friend, so Rockhoof belongs.
Oh!
You know, that reminds me of another story.
Once there was a small yak that knew more than a great hero.
Hey, don't forget the dragons in this one.
Aye, there were dragons and ponies. And plenty of hippogriffs, plus a changeling
okay.
And a griffin.
Okay. All right. Now, this is the definition of a pleasant surprise when it comes to an episode of MLP. I did not expect much at all going into this. I thought, oh god, and a whole episode about Rockhoof. There's not that many dimensions to the guy. He's the big brawny one with the shovel. I don't remember all too much about his personality, except that he was a hero, obviously. You know, I thought there's not really a way we can make this super interesting. It's gonna be another episode that leaves me feeling like the Huffields and McColts did, where I was just all blared out, like... Like, even for someone as easily as entertained as me, that season 5 episode, like, really bored me, I think. And I just didn't find it interesting at all. Especially because it didn't put any meaningful or interesting variation on that tired old warring families trope. This was a lot different. I really respect what this episode did. Not only as a reliable and interesting and well thought out follow-up to the positions of all of the pillars except for Star Swirl, you know, I love that we got all that pointed out. That was actually really cool. And everyone's roles made sense. Everyone seems happy. Yeah, we have got that continuity established of this is where each of those ponies are in the world, so they can easily be integrated into future episodes. You know, they might play some sort of big part in season 9, who knows? But yeah, this episode was deceiving, because with it being named after Rockhoof, of course, the main point was about him and how he struggled to fit in after being gone for so long based on his specific build and personality type. But I really didn't expect this. I didn't expect that we'd also be getting a look at the lives of the other pillars, which is so good. Oh, I really love that they had the opportunity to do this and they grabbed it by the throat. Like, that's what I love about the bold direction that MLP started going after the season 4 finale. Some people fell off the wagon with the show, especially because of Starlight and stuff, but I think all of this change and all of this bold endeavor has made the show so much more interesting. Without all of this that's been happening, that people complained about, with all the status quo changes and stuff, without all of this, I'd have dropped MLP a long time ago. I'm being really real here. I love this show and consider Starlight and Trixie my favourite characters because of all this change and development that's always happening, because of these new elements that aren't just focused on the main six all the time. You know, they are what started the show, but they're not all of what makes the show. I think having so many different pools to draw from instead of just relying on the same narrow group to milk an infinite number of episodes out of enriches the show so much and makes it that much more interesting to experience. It's made it so much more enjoyable for me than I ever found it in the first three seasons. Back then, it was, this is an above-average cartoon that really gets me. I really like how this is going. It's exactly on my level. But the direction MLP went after that went above my level. And I rose to meet it, and I loved it. I loved it so much. And I still do love it. Season 8 is shaping up to be an absolutely kick-ass season with this latest run of episodes. Oh my goodness, this is good. And the icing on the cake has to be Yona Yak. She was already my favourite student, and an episode like this only raises her several notches higher. When the Yaks first appeared, I found them amusing. I found them quite hilarious, actually. You know, these, like, brutish, beastly, destructive Yaks. And, you know, they're coming from a wintry land, which makes sense. You know, a lot of people were a little annoyed that the concept of the Yak seemed to be dumbed down to just being these savages, and oh, with the background they seemed to come from, they could have done a lot more interesting stuff with them. I saw a lot of hate for the Yaks from certain places, including one of my Skype friends, which is maybe why it stuck with me in my head that there was a problem with the Yaks. But I have quite enjoyed the Yak gimmick from Yona's perspective. Like, I think it really freshened up that whole thing when Yona came into the picture for this season, because she is, like, on the precipice between pony culture and Yak culture, so this window of innocence and fun and, like, learning and stuff, it's been so good to see. You know, from both an entertainment perspective and a character perspective, she's a very interesting student to me, because she's got the pre-ingrained traditions of a Yak, but she's also very quickly learning about the pony way of life. It's so cool! And the fact that she's found a pony who she can completely relate to, with the destructiveness, the big build, like, he's so tall and bulky. And, you know, his general penchant for telling these action-y tales that the whole class loves and stuff. I really think it's sweet that him and Yona have built this bond. Like, I did not expect that. Yet it makes so much freaking sense. So, basically, Yona has got her own Rainbow Dash-like connection. Like Scootaloo and Rainbow Dash. Yona has got Rockhoof, and I think that's fantastic. And the way he gets into his stories, I think he could be a great stage play narrator, or if he was able to tone down the destruction, I think with his theatrics, he'd be a good thespian, but I'm sure you'd have to typecast him. Yeah. Really good. Oh my goodness. I think I'm going to cap this off for tonight and continue my binge tomorrow, because this, I feel, was a perfect hot streak of three of episodes that I adored. Especially this one, because it was, as I say, the definition of a pleasant surprise. The thing that really shocked me, though, was that he pretty much wanted to have himself stoned, which is pretty much close to suicide, because although he would technically not be deceased, he wouldn't be, existing in the same plane anymore, you know, he'd be in stasis. And we know that there's been a little bit of equestrian revisionism in their history textbooks, because they say that Discord was put in a sleep state when, as we know, when he was refrozen and they discussed reforming him before he was unbroken for Keep Calm and Flutter On, he mentioned overhearing Celestia while he was still frozen. So he was conscious and he was listening. And yeah, is it any wonder why the moment he breaks free, the first thing he wants to do is cause some chaos? Come on, you've had so much time to stew and get angry about your situation. No one could blame him. So it's Equestria sort of decided to scrub that little bit out to make it look less cruel of a punishment. This guy was causing some mischief, so we put him to sleep for a bit. Not trapped him in a living hell for a couple thousand years and then hope he'd be chill if he ever came back, you know. Rockhoof did not realize that he would be basically dooming himself to an eternal hell of being able to see but not being able to scream. You know, that's where my brain's going with that, so I'll just stop there. But I think that was really dark that he just brought that up, oh, I don't belong anywhere, just do away with me. But that's just pretty close in TVY as to inferring suicide, aside from shooting yourself into a manticore mouth, as you can get. That's just the vibe I was getting. He was so down that they threw in a TVY thing about how, oh, just take me out of this world. Maybe I've been on the internet too long. Maybe I've been around dark shit too long. That's just where my brain starts going. Obviously this is about my honest thoughts, and that's what came to mind. But getting off that dark topic, wow, what an episode. Very, very impressed. Definitely a top 10 episode, especially because of how it surprised me. Wow. It says a lot about the correctness of people saying it really ramps up towards the end of the season that three episodes in a row I've said this is in my top 10. That really does sum it up. Anyways, I'll see you guys next time.